एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे टू ऑफ वीक वन इंट्रोडक्टरी प्रोग्राम ऑफ बैक टू बेसिक्स. आई एम निकिता, योर कोच फॉर द डे, एंड आई विल बी टेकिंग यू थ्रू द अपर बॉडी वर्कआउट. आई होप यू हैड अ गुड प्रीवियस लोअर बॉडी वर्कआउट विद नितीश. अ फ्यू पॉइंटर्स टू रिमेंबर बिफोर वी गेट स्टार्टेड विद द वर्कआउट. नंबर वन, मेक श्योर यू हैव योर लाइफस्टाइल स्कोर हैंडी, because we will be using that to decide your repetitions for the workout. Second one, keep your water bottle ready. All right, let's get straight into the workout. We'll be starting with the warm-up. The warm-up has two different movements. The first one is inchworm and the second one is snow angels. So for the inchworms, you have to stand at the back of the mat. Make sure your legs are slightly wider such that when you bend, your knees should not get folded. From this position, walk your hands forward in a plank position such that your palms are under the shoulders. Walk back and stand. If you struggle to do this version of inchworms, what you can do, you can get down on your knees, place your palms on the floor, walk forward in a knee plank, and then walk back. So that's your inchworms. The second movement is going to be snow angels. For that, we are going to lie down on our stomach. We'll start the movement while keeping our hands on our hips, palm facing the ceiling. First step, pull your shoulders back. Move your arms all the way forward and then back again. Make sure you keep your arms as away from the floor as possible. All right, so these were the two movements of your warm-up. Now, how are we gonna do it? We will be doing two sets, 7 reps of inchworms and 14 repetitions of snow angels. So let's get started. Stand at the end of your mat, go in a plank position, walk back and stand again. Go forward and back. When you stand, make sure you breathe in and breathe out and go again. That's 3-4 more reps to go. Last 3 repetitions. Make sure your hips are neither too low nor too high. They should be in line with your shoulder. And stand back up, breathe in, breathe out, last 2 reps, and last one. Okay, good one. Now we're gonna move to the second movement, which is a snow angel. So lie down on your stomach.
And let's get started. Remember, your shoulders should be pulled back before you start each rep and move slowly in this movement. You'll mostly feel it around your scapula. That's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, last 4 guys, keep moving slowly. 12, 13, and 14.
So this was our first set of the warm-up. We're gonna repeat it one more time, starting with inchworms again. So stand at the back of your mat and let's go. When you stand up, breathe in, breathe out. That's 2 and 3. Make sure you walk with your full palm on the floor, not just with your fingers. That's 4, 5, Last one. And done. All right. Moving on to snow angels now. Let's lie down on our stomach. Make sure
you rest your forehead on the floor. Palms behind. Pull the shoulders back. And start moving slowly. Try and keep your arms as away from the floor as possible. Pull the shoulder back before you start each rep. That's 6, 7, 8, 9. If you get tired, feel free to take a pause. 11, 12, last two, 13, and 14.
All right, so that was our warm up. Now we are going to move straight into the mobility part. We are going to do the mobility for our upper back and deltoids because we are going to be using them a lot in today's workout. So the first one is puppy dog. For the puppy dog, keep your knees on the floor. Extend your arms forward such that your hips stay above your knees. From here, touch your chin or your chest or your forehead to the floor. Wherever you feel comfortable, and we'll hold it for 30 seconds. So in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Hold. While you hold this position, keep pushing your armpits to the floor to feel more stretch in your lats and your upper back. Be there, guys. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and relax.
Moving on to the second one. This is called as deltoid to floor. The position is going to be same. You will be on your knees. What you have to do, you just have to spread your arms wider such that the fingers are facing opposite sides. Okay? From here, we are going to bend one elbow and touch our other chest or shoulder to the floor. Then come back up and do the same thing with the other side. We're going to be doing this for 30 seconds again. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Slowly move from one side to other. You'll feel a nice stretch around your pec. If you want to hold for a longer time, you can. And then slowly change. Last 5 seconds. And relax. All right, we'll take a quick 30 seconds breather, have some water, and then we'll directly move into the workout. For the workout today, we actually have two different parts. Part one has push-ups and ATYT, and second part is going to be HIIT. All right, let's get to it. So guys, for the push-ups, I will be showing you three different variations. You go with whichever you feel the most comfortable. First of all, what does an actual push-up looks like? So you get into a palm plank where your palms are under the shoulders, body in one straight line, keep your core and butt really tight. From here, you bend your elbows, go down, touch your chest to the floor and press up. That's what an actual push-up looks like. Now, if you're somebody who struggles with this, what you can do, you come in a plank position, drop your knees from there such that your body is in one straight line, bend your elbows, lie down on the floor completely and press up. You can try this one as well. This last version, if you have access to a table, chair, anything, just stand in front of it, place your palms on the top of it. From there, bend your elbows, go forward and press back up. Go forward and press back up. This is actually a very good variation for developing the strength of push-ups. How you can go about it? As you feel that your strength is increasing, you can lower the height and try the same thing. So that was your first movement. The second movement is an ATYT. Now this movement is actually very good for people who have long standing or sitting hours. So you simply have to lie down on your stomach, forehead on the floor. We'll start from the A position where your arms are closer to your hips, thumbs are pointing the ceiling. You have to lift your arm in A, then go to T, lift your arms, then go to Y, lift your arms, then go to T again. We'll try two more reps. Let's go. A, T, Y, and T. Last one. A, T, Y, and T. Okay, I hope you are clear with the two movements of part one. Now, how we are going to do it? You remember I told you that you have to keep your license score handy because we will be using that in the workout. So your workout is every minute on the minute for 14 minutes. This is called as EMOM. That means you will be doing one movement in each minute for certain seconds. Now, if your license score is less than 60, in the first minute, you will be doing 30 seconds of push-ups. If it's between 60 to 80, you will be doing 35 seconds of push-ups. If it's above 80, you will be doing 40 seconds of push-ups. Okay? Same goes for your ATYT. If your license score is less than 60, 30 seconds of ATYT, 60 to 80, 35 seconds, above 80, 40 seconds. Okay? So are you ready? Let's have some water. And then we will get started with the workout. All right. Cool. Starting in, we're gonna do push-ups first at the odd minute. Starting in 3, 2, 1, and go. Stick to whichever version you can move fast with. I will do 4 reps of full push-ups and then I'm changing it to knee push-ups. Make sure you count your reps. Keep going, guys. And rest. Okay, I did it for 30 seconds. If you're going for 35 seconds, now the time is over. And in 3, 2, 1, 40 seconds. Relax, catch your breath, walk up and down the mat. The next movement is going to be ATYT. All right, get ready for the same. 3, 2, 1, and go. That's one, again, A, T, Y, and T, keep moving, A, T, Y, and T, last five, okay, 30 seconds are up, keep moving, 35 up, and 40 up. Rest for 20 seconds. We are done with the first set of part one workout. We'll be starting with the push-ups again. Get ready, guys. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Feel free to stick to the version. You can move fast in and make sure your form is also right. Keep moving. Okay, 30 seconds are up. 35 up. And 40 up. We'll be moving to 80YT in 10 seconds. Get ready, lie down on your floor. 3, 2, 1, let's go. A, T, Y, and T. A, T, Y, and T. Keep moving. A, T, Y, and T. Almost there. A, T, Y, and T. 30 seconds are up. 35 up. And 40 seconds are up. Good job, guys. We are done with two sets. That means total of 4 intervals. We are left with 10 more intervals. That means 5 more sets. This time, I'm going to go with knee push-ups throughout. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep moving, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, 30 seconds are up. I got 14 reps. 35 up. And 40 up. Good job, guys. 20 seconds breather. 3. Try to get the same number of reps you are getting in the previous intervals. Alright, get ready for the ATYT. Lie down on the floor and let's go. A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A, keep moving, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, and T. 30 seconds are up, 35 up, and 40 up. Catch your breath, have some water. Doing good, guys. We are done with 5 intervals. And we'll be moving to push-ups now. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you get tired, make sure you take a breather on the top. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Rest. Okay, sorry, 30 up. If you're doing for 35, 35 seconds are up. And now, 40 up. When you're resting, inhale and exhale through your nose. That helps you in recovering faster. Almost the time. Lie down on your stomach. 3, 2, 1,
go. A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T,
almost there, A,
T, Y, and T.
30 seconds up, 35 up, and now 40 up. Moving well, guys. 4 sets are done. We are left with 3 more sets. 10 seconds to go. Let's take our position. Push-ups. If you're doing knee push-ups, start in a high plank. Drop your knees and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, 30 up, 35 up, and 40 up. 20 seconds rest. Make sure you keep hydrating yourself. Almost there we are. All right. On the floor in 3, 2, 1,
go. A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, almost there, A, T, Y,
and T. 30 seconds up, 35 up, and 40 up. Good job, guys. Move up and down. We are done with 5 sets now. Last 2 to go. All right. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last 10, 11. Okay, 30 up, 35 up, and 40 seconds up. Okay, I started with 15 reps of push-ups, but now I'm able to do only 12 in each round. So it's okay if your numbers have gone down a little down, it's completely fine. Try to stick to it. In 3, 2, 1, ATYD, lie down on your stomach and go.
A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y,
T, almost there.
A, T, Y,
T, 30 seconds up, 35 up, and then 40 up, guys. Last set to go for part one. Have some water. Breathe. Let yourself recover. Get ready. 3, 2, 1, and go. Last set, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, 30 seconds are up. 35 up. And then 40 up. Good one, guys. Last interval to go. I hope you're having fun while working out at the same time. Okay, let's go. Lie down on your stomach. In 3, 2, 1, begin. A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A, T, Y, T, A. Your shoulders must be feeling really tired by now. And 30 seconds up. 35 up. And then 40 up. Good job, guys. This was part one. We are going to take a 1 minute breather and we'll be moving to our second part, which is HIIT. It's a good one and slightly tough as well at the same time, but we will get it done. So just to explain you the workout, we have two different movements. The first one is a dumbbell upright row. The second one is burpees. I'm going to show you how you can do these movements first. We'll give you the scaled options if you are not able to do the actual version. And then we'll explain you the workout. Okay, so are you ready? Let's go. The first one is a dumbbell upright row. For this one, you can either do it with one dumbbell or two dumbbells. First, I'll show you how you can do it with two dumbbells. So you're going to stand straight. Make sure your feet are under your hips, toes pointing forward. Hold the dumbbell in front of your body horizontally. From here, you're going to shrug and pull the dumbbells higher. Shrug, pull the dumbbells higher. Make sure your elbows are pointing the ceiling when you do that. If you don't have two dumbbells and have access to just one dumbbell, you can hold that from the side and then pull higher. Again, shrug, pull higher. Shrug, pull higher. So that's a dumbbell upright row. Which muscle group is actually used in this one? It's your traps. It's to build them. The second one is a burpee. What does an actual burpee look like? I think you must have heard the burpee and must have tried it also. But I'll show you one more time. So for the burpee, you stand, bend forward, place your palms on the floor, kick back, lie down, make sure your entire body touches the floor, press up, kick forward, and stand. If you find this one too tough, what you can do, bend forward, step back with other leg, lie down, press up, step forward, stand. I will give you one more simpler version. If you are a beginner, please start the burpee with this one. Keep a chair or a table in front of you. Keep your hand on it. Kick back, kick forward, stand. If you don't want to kick, place your hands on the bench, step back, step forward, and stand. This was slightly higher, So it didn't feel that much tough, but you can lower the height to make it accordingly challenging for you. Okay? Now, what we're gonna do, it's an HIIT, like I told you, there are three different types of repetitions that you can do. Again, if your license score is less than 60, you will be doing 12, 9, and 6. What does that mean? 12 repetitions of dumbbell upright row, followed by 12 burpees, 9 upright rows, 9 burpees, 6 upright rows, 6 burpees. Okay? If your license score is between 60 to 80, you will be doing 15, 12, 9. If it's above 80, you will be doing 21, 15, 9. Okay? So I will be going with 15, 12, and 9, the middle one. Okay? You can see which one you want to go with based on your lifestyle score. One more thing, this workout can become very tough, like as soon as you start, because it involves burpees. So please make sure you do them mindfully. Do one rep, stand up, catch your breath, and then again go. That way you will be able to go at a consistent pace. Just don't start too fast, otherwise you can get breathless quickly. Okay, let's have a quick sip of water and we are going to start with the workout. All right. Okay, one more thing. I'm going to give you a time cap of 6 minutes for this workout. So we'll start at the 0th minute. And in 6 minutes, how much ever reps you are able to finish, that will be your score. If you are able to finish the entire workout, awesome. Okay? So if you are ready, we'll start in another 20 seconds. Make sure whatever things you require, they are in front of you. All right, starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go. We're gonna start with upright rows. 1, 2, 3. How are you gonna breathe in and breathe out? When you pull the dumbbell up, you breathe out. When you go down, you breathe in. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, last two for me, 14, 15. Okay, moving on to the burpees. One, remember, catch your breath. Breathe in, breathe out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Breathe in, breathe out. 7, 8, 9, inhale, exhale, 10, 11, 12, last three for me, 13, 14, 15. Okay, 15 and 15 are done. We're gonna move to 12 and 12 now. Let's go pick up the dumbbells and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So 2 minutes, 50 seconds are up. Moving on to 12 burpees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep moving. I know it's tough. Just try to maintain your pace. Don't go too fast. 7, 8, 9, 10. Last two for me. 11, 12. Okay, I will have a quick sip of water. Okay, last round, guys. 9 and 9, starting with the upright rows. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last 9 burpees. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Stand up, catch your breath, and go down. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, we are left with 30 seconds. Please keep moving. We'll stop at 6. Keep moving. Last 10 to go. And 5, 4, 3, 2, and done. Good job, guys. Please sit down. If you want to remove your shoes, you can. And close your eyes for a while. We are just going to catch our breath. What we'll do, breathe in, expand your belly, breathe out, contract your belly. Just be there for 30 seconds. Okay, once your heart rate has come down, you will switch to box breathing. What is box breathing? I think you must have done it in the previous workout as well. We will take 4 seconds to inhale, 4 seconds hold our breath, 4 seconds to exhale, and 4 seconds hold over there in the exhale. Okay, so let's get started. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, exhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4. Exhale. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4. One more time. Inhale. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4. Exhale. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4. Okay. Slowly rub your palms together. Place them on your eyes. And then slowly open up. Good job, guys. I hope you felt good. Now we're going to move straight to the cool down. We're going to stretch our muscles, which we used a lot in the workout. So your first movement is going to be armless prayer. This is for stretching your triceps and slightly our upper back as well. So what we'll do, we are going to sit down in a Vajrasana. From there, we're going to extend our arms forward, bend the elbow, and then place your palms on the upper back. Just be there. What you can do is push down your elbows in the floor. We're going to hold it for 30 seconds. Be there. Inhale and exhale. Try to relax. With each exhale, try to go deeper in the stretch. That means push down your elbows more in the floor. Okay, 30 seconds are up. The next one is a seated pec stretch. For this one, you're going to sit down on the floor. Keep your legs forward, palms behind on the floor, such that the fingers are facing the backside. From here, keeping the palms fixed, move your hips forward. Remember, you don't have to move your palms, only your hips are going to shift forward. Let's hold it for 30 seconds. Pull your shoulders back. This is the area where you will feel the stretch. Stay there. 10 more seconds. Three, two, one, relax. Okay. The last stretch is going to be the trap stretch. We are going to do the trap stretch with the dumbbell. So, pick up one dumbbell, hold it in your arm. I'm going to hold it in my right arm. And then I'm going to slowly bend my neck on the left side. I will feel the stretch here. Hold it for 30 seconds. Imagine the dumbbell is pulling your arm down. That's how you have to hold the dumbbell. Stay there. You did a lot of upright rows, so this is for that. The stretches will release your traps. And slowly bring your neck back. Change the side. Hold it in your left arm now. Bend your neck on the right side. Be there. Breathe in, breathe out. Keep pulling your arm down, or let your arm get pulled down with the dumbbell. 3, 2, 1, slowly bring your neck back. The last stretch is the kneeling wrist stretch. We did a lot of push-ups. So our forearms and also with the dumbbells, they get tight. So we're going to release them. Keep your knees on the floor, palms also on the floor in such a way that the palms are facing the floor and fingers are facing you. From here, you're gonna shift your hip back like this.
and hold it. This is the part where you feel the stretch. 30 seconds. Hold it. 15 seconds to go. Be there. In 3, 2, 1, relax. Good job, guys. That was day 2 of introductory week of Back to Basics program. I hope you had fun. Tomorrow, we are going to be doing the PPP session, which is more related to mobility. That's all for today. Make sure you stay fit, stay healthy, and stick to the basics.